Superconductors are some of the most widely studied materials. To investigate the behavior of these materials, a small disc of superconducting ceramic is placed in a petri dish. A permanent magnet, 3.5 millimeters square, is placed on top of the ceramic disc. To observe how the magnet interacts with the superconductor, liquid nitrogen is used to cool the disc to its critical temperature, the point at which the material becomes superconductive. When the critical temperature for the disc of 93 Kelvin is reached, the magnet levitates. As long as the disc remains below the critical temperature, the magnet continues to hover a short distance above the surface of the disc. The levitation of the permanent magnet is caused by the repulsive forces between magnetic fields. Above the critical temperature, the ceramic disc is a normal conductor, and the magnetic field of the permanent magnet passes through it. During the transition from a normal to superconducting state, the superconductor expels all magnetic field lines passing through it, a physical behavior known as the Meissner effect. The change in the internal magnetic field from its original value down to zero induces electric current loops on the surface of the superconductor. With zero resistance, these currents flow without opposition, and the superconductor acts as a permanent magnet. The magnetic field created by the superconducting current opposes the field of the permanent magnet, just as two bar magnets oppose one another when like poles are brought together. The resultant force is strong enough to propel the magnet into the air above the disc. To more directly examine the zero resistance characteristics of high temperature superconductors, a specially constructed superconductive bar will be used. Attached to the superconductor are two sets of electrical leads that have been bonded to the bar with a conductive adhesive. One set of wires is attached to a DC power supply. Connected to the other set of leads is a voltmeter, which will measure the voltage drop across the superconductor. At the outset of the experiment, the power supply registers a source voltage of 11.5 volts and a current of 100 milliamps. The voltage drop across the superconductive sample is measured at 3.3 millivolts. According to Ohm's law, the resistance of the superconductor is calculated to be 0.03 ohms. As the sample is cooled in a bath of liquid nitrogen, the voltage drop across the superconductor is observed to decrease steadily. During its gradual drop, a point is reached when the voltage drop falls suddenly to zero. With zero drop in voltage, the bar has achieved a superconductive state, having zero resistance to electric current. The discovery of high-temperature superconductors, materials with transition temperatures from 50 to well over 100 Kelvin, has resulted in many scientific applications and might be the basis for future development of superconducting power transmission lines and superconducting magnetic trains.